Thank you for joining us today. I'm Rudy Stebby, and welcome to Episode 2, Setting Up Windows Messenger 2011 for the First Time, here on HelpDesk TV. It takes just a few minutes to download and set up Windows Messenger. Once you do, you'll be ready to begin chatting with friends, family, and coworkers in the next room or around the world. The process involves a few simple steps: making sure your computer has what it needs to run Windows Messenger, downloading Windows Messenger, and signing up for a Windows Live ID account. We've got a lot to cover, so let's begin right away. First, you have to download the Windows Messenger software and set up a free Windows Live ID account, if you don't have one already, so you can sign in to the program. If you haven't already downloaded Windows Messenger, please review our video, Installing Windows Live Essentials 2011, located on our website at www.helpdesktv.ca. It will be located under the Windows Live 2011 category. Once installed, the next step is to sign into Windows Live Messenger. First, you will need to launch Windows Live Messenger by clicking Start, All Programs, and then Windows Live Messenger. A window will pop up asking you for your login credentials. If you already have a Windows Live ID account, go ahead and enter your Live ID and password. If you don't already have a Windows Live ID account, you will need to create one. On the bottom of the window, click the Sign Up link to get started. Your browser will start, and the Create Your Windows Live ID page will display. If you have an existing email address, you can use that email address. And then enter a password you'd like to use with this account. Enter the rest of the information required, and don't forget to scroll down to see the additional fields. When done, click the I Accept button and follow the sign-up procedure for confirming your email address. If you don't have an existing email address, or would like to get a Windows Live email address, simply click on or get a Windows Live email address. The next screen that pops up will allow you to choose your new Windows Live email address. Fill in the information as required, not forgetting to scroll down and click the I Accept button when completed. Again, follow the sign up procedure screens that follow. Once you have your Windows Live ID account, return to the Windows Live Messenger sign-in screen and enter your newly created Windows Live ID information. If your information was entered correctly, you will be logged in and then be asked to where you want to start, either Social Highlights or MSN. I will select Social Highlights. Congratulations, you are now signed into Windows Live Messenger. You can now tell your friends how they can contact you with Windows Live Messenger, or if you're just starting out, you can use our Live Messenger ID to get started. Just click Add under Friends and type in helpdesktv@live.com and click Next. Obviously, I can't add myself, but please stop by after I've accepted you and tell me how I'm doing. Please make sure you visit our new website at www.helpdesktv.ca. There, you will find all our how-to videos clearly categorized for your quick retrieval. We also ask for you to use our tip buttons to donate a small amount of money to help offset the costs of providing these training and how-to videos to you every week. As a special hidden bonus that will be mentioned in this video only, if you donate an amount equal to $10 per month, not only will you be donating to offset the costs of providing these videos to you, I will provide to you a 2 to 4 hour response time for any PC-related problems for the length of the monthly donation. If you donate an amount equal to $5 a month, I will provide you with a 24-hour response time. And if you donate an amount equal to $2 a month, I will provide you with a 48-hour response time for any PC-related problem. This offer will not be mentioned again in any other video. This is a special hidden bonus to you for watching this video in its entirety. You can cancel at any time. I hope you enjoyed today's Help Desk TV. If you have a comment about this program, a question, or a shortcut you would like to share with me, send us an email message to feedback@helpdesktv.ca. Thanks for watching.